take one nice deep inhale together. Hold it at the top. And exhale all out. And then you need a tabletop.
So nice strong tabletop position to start. We're just going to start by warming up that belly a little bit, warming up that core. So nice strong tabletop, knees underneath the hips. We're just going to start by pressing away that floor. So really pull those shoulders down. Pressing, pressing, pressing. And then we're just going to add on by digging in those toes, lifting up those knees to hovering just over the mat. Keeping that back flat, really engage that core. So pull it in nice and tight, keep pushing away that floor. Let's take a few breaths here. So inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Draw the inner of the shoulder. two, and one. Let's set up that side plank for the other side. So center that right hand. Left foot in front this time. Stack those hips. Hold it tall for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and one. Draw that hand under the shoulder and reach it up tall for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, hold it tall for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, return to your straight arm plank position. This time, instead of dragging those knees down separately, I want you to bring those knees right to the elbows. So nice and wide. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one. Good. Push it back once more to that downward dog. Just for one breath. And then walk those feet forward to those hands. And go ahead and lie right down onto your back. Getting those hands right underneath those hips, we're going to start right over that rollover. So keeping the shoulders down, legs together, let's end those legs over. Open and exhale down. Press that lower back down, draw those legs to parallel, and close. Inhale. Open, exhale. And close. Inhale. Open, exhale. 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 Let's keep those legs open. And inhale over. Close and exhale. All the way parallel. Open and inhale. Close, exhale, keep those shoulders coming down. Open, inhale. Close, exhale, engage that core as you draw the legs down. Open, inhale. Close, exhale. Open, inhale. Close, exhale. Couple more. Open, inhale. Close, exhale. Open, inhale. Close and exhale. Let's hold those legs down now for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, legs over. Lift them tall, dropping hips, and then draw those legs down parallel and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and one. Again, inhale over. Lift. Exhale, release. Legs come down and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and one. Inhale over. Lift. This time we're just going to drop those hips, press that lower back down, engage those legs, drive them up for 10. 9, that lower back fly each time, 8, get the shoulders in up, 7, 6, use that lower belly, drive it up, last 4, 3, 2, and 1, good, press that lower back down, draw those legs back down to parallel, hold again for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift the head and shoulders up. Point the toes, cross those ankles. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4,
two. Last one, good. Bring both legs up, keeping that low back flat. We're just going to drop those legs in parallel. Lift those legs up, feet right over the hips. So just lower and lift. Nice easy movement. Try to keep those legs nice and straight. Keeping those hip flexors working. Keep those shoulders anchored down. Head is flat on the mat. Keep those palms flat underneath those hips. Draw those legs all the way to parallel if you can without compromising that lower back. So make sure there's not an arch in your back. If there is, you just come down as far as you can until that lower back starts to lift a little bit. Keep the breath steady. You're not lifting that tailbone. Just draw those feet right over the hips. 10 more. Squeeze that lower belly in and you draw those legs to parallel. 5 more. And then move into 100. In 3. 2. Last one. Legs stay up. Head and shoulders off the mat. Arms by your side. Start pumping those arms. So lift that chest as much as you can. Pull that belly in. Lower back should be flat. Legs nice and straight, glued together. You can have a slight bend in those knees if you need to. But keep those shoulders pulled down away from the ears. Nice strong arms, so nice and engaged. Engage those triceps even. Keeping that high gaze right down center. Chin close to your chest, protect your neck. Nice steady inhales and exhales. Try to match those inhales and exhales. Up to 4 counts for that inhale and exhale too. Focus right down center for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower those legs to halfway. Keep them nice and straight. Really draw in that belly again. Maybe lift that chest a little bit higher for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop that right leg to parallel. So those legs are scissored. They're going to stay right there for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Swap it out for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Left foot meets the right, so go back to halfway for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Draw the legs back up straight again. Keep pumping those arms for the last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now step those hands behind your head, elbows nice and wide. We're going to drop the left leg, bring the left elbow to the outside of the right knee, and bring it back center. So we'll be doing 20 of these before we go to the other side. So right leg stays straight. Right elbow is open nice and wide. Nice deep twist. Bring it right out, pulling the lower belly in as you bring that left elbow over to the right side. Opening up that left elbow nice and wide when you drop that head back. Keep that left leg nice and straight if you can. Bring it all the way to parallel. Shift that eye gaze to the edge of your mat as you twist. Nice exhales as you bring it out. So when you exhale to the right, and then inhale as you open it up. Halfway there. Try to make that elbow connection each time, so really lift that shoulder. Keep that right elbow off the floor. Last 5. And then we'll go right to the other side. In 2. And 1. So now take it to the other side, dropping the right leg, right elbow to the outside of that left knee. That belly pull in. Keep that right leg straight. halfway there.
Reverse now. So take it left. Nice big circles going this way too. Remember all those points. Keep your stands underneath those steps. Palms are flat. Shoulders pull down. Head is flat. You're looking at one spot on the ceiling. Keep those feet touching. Make a nice big circle. Together. plenty of these. So remember your points for this. Again, head is flat, shoulders pulled down. Keep that belly in tight. Keep those heels together, toes open. Bring those heels close to your backside, full extension when you slide those heels out. One, reach the other side. inhalation on the work out, pull up belly and lift that head, hold. Look at the top of your mat for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now elbow to knee connection for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, good. Now reach that arm right under the shoulder, pull it through for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Return to your elbow plank position, let's roll it out one more time for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Bring it up to the straight arm point. Open up those hands nice and wide. 10 push-ups for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Drop those knees. Let's bring it to tabletop. Let's do some bird dog variations. So let's extend the left leg and extend the right arm. Keeping those hips square. Reach and pull that arm and leg. Good. Thigh gaze down. Press into the floor with that left hand. Now let's connect the knee to the elbow and extend. For 10. Keep the belly tight. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it back together and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Extend it down. Now bring it out to the diagonal. We'll do the same thing. Bring it over to the outside of the knee, heart center, and extend for 10. Working out oblique. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pull it back in and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it back to tabletop. Let's do the other side. So extend the right leg and the left arm. Reach and pull to start. Pull the belly and square up the hips. Now let's bring the knee to the elbow and extend for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it together and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Extend. Bring it out to the diagonal. And then bring the elbow to the outside of the knee and extend for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then bring it back together and hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Drop it down to that tabletop. Dig the toes in. Push it up and back. Downward dog. Come on, those feet together. Stretch it out here for one breath. And then walk those feet forward. And we'll return onto our back. Good. So let's start with single leg stretch. The whole one again. Extend the other leg long and just walk it out. So nice, easy move. Press that lower back down. Keep that belly in. Shoulders off the mat. High knees right down center. Keep that chin lifted though. Keep those elbows in. Point those toes. Keep that leg fully extended if you can. Nice and straight and parallel. For 10, 9, 8, Good. Bring those legs to tabletop for a moment. Stack those hands behind your head and super broad crunches. Bring those heels together, toes open. Lift that chest, elbows right to the knees. Drop them all back. Send those legs. Bring it center and extend. So we'll do 20 of these, so keep your lower back flat. Lifting that chest as much as you're drawing those knees in to make that elbow to knee connection. Pressing those heels away. Bringing those legs as close to parallel as you can while keeping that lower back flat. Opening up those elbows nice and wide. Hold your breath. Exhale when you draw it all together. 10 more now. And then we're going to move into bicycles. You're going to keep your hands right behind your head. Last 5, 3, 2, last one, and right into bicycles. So twist it out, pulling that knee in, extending that other leg long. Lifting your chest, lifting your shoulder nice and high, looking at the edge of your mat as you twist. Make that elbow to knee connection every time. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one now, hold whatever side you're on, move the edge of your mat, pull that belly in, lower back is flat, pull that knee in as tight as you can, extend that other leg nice and long, for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, right to the other side, pull that knee in tight, lift that chest, for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, back to the other side, for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, other side, last 9, for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, good, we're going to drop those feet flat to the floor, bring those hands to prayer, we're just going to drop those arms through center, lifting that chest nice and high, and then pull it back a little bit, so little pulses, for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pull it through and hold. So pull that belly in, lift that chest as high as you can. Pull the shoulders down away from the ears. Feet are flat. Feet and knees hip width apart. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to little pulses. We're going to build for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pull it through and hold for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lift it higher for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to pulses for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6,
We're going to drop those knees to hovering right on our right side. Nice deep twist. Bring it back center and bring it to the other side. So you go at your own pace. So we're just going to bring it out here. So a couple of points. Let's keep those shoulders pulled down to the floor, keeping the palms flat. Head should be flat on the floor. Your belly's pulled in nice and tight. You can stay tight through this whole move. You're keeping those legs bent. Knees together, feet touch. Good. Bringing those legs all the way to parallel. So you're trying to keep that top knee in line with that hip when you drop it down. Everything in a nice straight line. And bringing it out. And you tend the right side. So you definitely have your feet touching. You're trying to keep those knees as close together as you can. Five more each side. Another hold on your side. And three. Last one each side. Good. Now bring it to one side and hold. Get that top knee in line with that hip. Pull it back. So shoulder down for 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stay here for a second. If that works, have those legs nice and long. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Draw the feet in if they were extended. Bring it back up to tabletop. Drop it to the other side. So bring it out. Pull the belly in. The opposite shoulder down, keep those legs parallel, hold it here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stay here for that second set or extend the legs with me for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pulling those feet in, drop legs up to tabletop, and then just drop those feet right down to the floor. Keep the feet and knees touching. Bring the heels in nice and close to that back side, and just lift those hips up. Keep those arms where they are, extended. Extend the right leg out, flex the foot. We're going to keep it flexed, drop it to parallel, pick the toes, and lift that leg high. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep the leg up there. Let's pulse. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's repeat that. So flex and point. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep up there and pulse for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Bring that right foot down. Readjust those hips. Bring those feet together. Let's do the left side. So draw it up. Flex and point for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pulse for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Again, flex and point for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pulse for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Drop it down. Keep those knees ahead. Let's move right into some leg work. So, come on to your side. Let's stack those feet at the front corner of our mat. Resting your head in your hand. Make sure those hips stay stacked and belly stays in. Top leg does the work. So we're going to flex that foot
to the front and then to the back of that bottom leg. Try to keep that top leg nice and straight. Keep that belly in tight. Five more. Take it back. So when you drive that heel back, you can push that chest forward.
two. And one.
Good.
Now bring those knees together. Bend your feet. Bend your knees. And extend. Again, push that chest forward when you drive that leg back. Five more, and we'll do small circles. Last one. Good, now draw that leg forward, point the toes, small circles. For 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's reverse for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Let's stretch that. So come onto your back. Cross over the leg over again. Grab onto those feet. Let's pull those heels in, keeping our shins parallel. Pull those elbows in, pull the shoulders down, lift that tailbone high. Then release those hands, drop those twisted knees to your side. Gently pressing down that top end of your hand, extending that opposite arm, pulling the shoulder down. Ready to our yoga. Let's start the link removing pose. So let's drop that left leg down and then pull that right knee in toward your right shoulder. Interlacing those fingers underneath the right knee. We're just going to begin to pull that right knee toward that shoulder. Now while you keep those fingers interlaced, let's pull those shoulders down. Back of your leg is flat, elbows pulled in. Draw your chin right to your chest line. Relax that left leg, relax that right foot. Use that bicep straight to keep pulling that knee in. Good, coming up all that blood circulation. Keep pulling with every breath. Pull those shoulders down even more. Hold here, couple of breaths. Good, and then release that, dropping that right leg to the floor as you bring that left knee into the left shoulder. Interlacing those fingers, same points on this side. So pull those shoulders down again, pull the elbows in. Use that bicep strength. Keep those fingers in our legs, keep pulling that left knee toward that shoulder. Draw your chin even closer to your chest. Good, nice flat back. Relax your right leg, relax your left foot. Focus on that arm strength, bringing that knee closer and closer to that shoulder with every breath. Couple more breaths. Good, and then release. And then right away, pull both knees in. And when you're doing a pinnacle leg, grab on the opposite elbows forming. Pull those shoulders down, bring your chin back to your chest. Keeping those feet connected, I want you to push those knees together as well. Good. And now I want your eye gaze to fall on that diamond that you've created between your forearms and your knees. So squeeze those knees together, keep looking at that diamond, pull those shoulders down. Really try to flatten your back here. Some nice thin inhales and exhales, pressing that lower back right into the floor. Those knees together, keep pulling those shoulders down. Draw that chin closer to your chest. Couple more breaths. Good, and then let it go. Let's bring those arms overhead. Let's drop those legs to the floor. Give it a nice good morning stretch. Good. And then round yourself up and flip the ring over into tabletop. Good, so if you were in a tabletop position, let's just do some shoulder stretches before you're ready to stand. So extend that right arm tall, your flat to the floor, rolling onto that right shoulder. Good. Now take that left arm. If you like, you can bind it. So bring it to your lower back, or even to that right thigh. If you want to get fancy, you can extend that left leg out, pressing that left foot into the floor, press that ear right into the mat, nice and deep. And then coming back out, let's return that left hand to the floor, pull that knee in if it was extended, bring that right leg to the left, back tabletop. So extend that left arm, let's do the other side, thread it through, roll onto that shoulder to start, press that left ear down, and then you can add that bind, so extend that right arm up and back, then you can extend that right leg if you want to, and just really press that ear into the floor. Bring that right hand back to the mat, pull that leg in, and return that left hand to the floor, your back and tabletop. Good, dig those toes in, push it up and back to downward dog. You can walk with those heels a little bit. Just stretch it out, which means to be here. And then walk those feet forward to those hands, and let's slowly rise. So before we flow, let's do a little bit more deep stretching. So bring those feet together. Bring those arms up overhead, interlace those fingers, release the index fingers and cross the thumbs. Reach it tall, pull the belly in. Good. And then begin to drop those arms to your right. So keeping those arms glued right to your head. Framing your head. Use that right hand to pull that left arm over. Keep that belly in. Keep those hips and shoulders square. Press into the outside of that left foot. With every breath, going a little bit deeper. Finding that strength. Lean right into it. One more breath. Good. And then bring it back center, reach it tall. And let's drop it to the other side. So same thing on this side, same points. You're keeping those shoulders and hips square. Keep that belly in. That left hand to reach that right arm over. Pressing into the outside of that right foot this time. Should feel nice for the stretch on the right side. Should feel really good. Come to that deepest point with your next breath. And then bring it back center. Good. Let's bring those hands right down to prayer. And let's walk right to the front of our mat. So to begin our flow, bringing those feet together, hands in prayer. We're going to inhale those arms up tall. And then we're going to exhale those hands all the way onto the mat. We're going to inhale the flat back, hands to our shins, looking forward. And then exhale, fingertips down, and we're going to walk those feet back to our plank position. And then we're going to move through our vinyasa. So nice and slow, keep the elbows in close to your side, just lower yourself down. And then flip those toes and move right into an upward dog. So press the leg up forward, pull those shoulders down and back. Keep those knees off the mat. And then move through plank and maybe in downward dog. Dropping those heels nice and close to the floor, arms in nice and close. Belly in, push that chest. Good. Now walk those feet forward. Hands to our hips, and slowly rise. Good. Now, bring those feet hip width apart. Bring those arms out. So you want your hands in line with those shoulders. So pull the shoulders down, pull the belly in. Take a nice deep inhale, and exhale down into your seated chair position. So keep the chest lifted. Keep those fingertips extended, pull those shoulders down and back. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Keep that belly in, keep the weight on those heels. Good. And then just release. You're going to grab onto those big toes with your peace fingers. Drop that head heavy. Bending at the elbows. Bring the weight forward into those toes. Begin to pull on those toes. Keeping the chest on those sides. Begin to straighten out those legs. So use that bicep strength here. Pull those shoulders down away from the ears. Bring that body weight forward, keep stretching. Release those hands, bring those arms up, back into that seated chair.
And then slowly rise. Good, arms by your side, walk again to the front of your mat, let's flow. Bring those arms up overhead. Exhale down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, release. Step those feet back to your plank position. Bring it down through your vinyasa, right into your upward dog. Good, move through plank, right to downward dog. And let's extend that right leg. Let's bring that right foot through. Drop that left knee, top of your left foot. And moving into this variation of crescent, extending those arms. Good. Hold here. Bring those hands down to prayer position. Twist into it. Left elbow on the outside of that knee. Bring those hands down, frame that foot. Slowly walk those fingertips back. You're going to sit right on that left heel, keeping that right leg extended. You can stay right here or you can flex that foot. Use that opposite hand, you can grab onto that foot, grab onto that big toe, and you can just slowly begin to bring yourself down. Hold here for one more breath. Good. And we're going to return to that crescent, keeping that left knee on the floor. So here we are, we're going to make it more of a runner's lunge. So walk that foot forward a little bit and just press right into it. Really leaning into that hip flexor. Good. And we're going to take those left toes in. Shoot the right leg back to meet the left. And move your vinyasa, so bring it down into your upward dog. Move through plank, downward dog. And let's do the other side. So extend the left leg. Bring that left foot through. Nice deep runner's lunge. Drop the right knee, top of your right foot. Good. Extend those arms tall, holding this modified crescent. Hands fall down to prayer, twist it out. Right elbow to the outside of the left knee. Good. Release those hands to bring that foot. Slowly walk those fingertips back until you're sitting on that right heel, keeping that left leg extended. You can sit here, you can flex that foot, grab onto that foot with your right hand, opposite hand. Bowing that head down. Nice deep hamstring stretch. Good, release. Walk those fingertips forward. Walk that left foot forward a little bit. Push that chest right into that thigh, palms are flat. Nice, strong. to your limit, you can bring those elbows down. If you can go even further, bring the top of the head down. Final expression, bring those arms up overhead, grab them on opposite elbows. Bring your chin to the chest. Keep the hip and heel connection. Keeping those knees touching the floor. Try to keep those knees close together if you can. Pull the shoulders down, lift that chest, squeeze those elbows. Holding here for a couple of breaths. Bring that leg back center. Swap out the hands so that left hand comes to the outside of your right foot, extending the right arm, and just guiding that right leg ever so gently over that left. Good. Bring it back center. Let's swap it out. So drop the right leg and bring that left hand to the outside of your left foot and open it up. And then bring it back center, bring that right hand to the outside of your left foot, extend the left arm, gently guide that left leg over. Give those knees a little height for me. And then round yourself up. Coming back to tabletop, we're going to move into puppy pose. So get those knees underneath the hips. And you need to walk those hands out until those hands and shoulders, elbows too, are all in one nice straight line. Bring that chin right to the mat. chin, walking those hands back to your tabletop position. Let's do some cat and cow. So bring your chin to your chest, round the back, pull the shoulders down, palms are flat. And then drop the belly, look up for me, press the way up forward again. Again, round the back, chin to your chest. And drop the belly, look up. Good, and bring it back to neutral. Extend the left leg and bring the left toes to the outside, the right side of your mat, and look over that right shoulder. If you want to add the bind, you can bring that right hand to your lower back, looking over that shoulder, pulling it back. Good. Release that hip to the mat. Pull the left knee in. Let's do the other side. So extend the right leg. Bring that foot to the outside of the left side of your mat. Looking over the left shoulder. You can add the bind. But pull that shoulder back. Good. And then release. Good. Now open up those knees nice and wide. Bring those feet together. Back and child's pose. So extend those arms nice and long. Bring that forehead and down. Bring that chest forward. Good. Bring those hands back. Bring those knees together. So you're sitting on those heels. Good. I want you to grab onto the inside of your feet. So your fingers are on the inside, your thumbs are on the outside. Keep those knees together. Keep the hip and heel connection. Draw your chin to your chest. Round the shoulders in and begin to curl into yourself. Bring that forehead and head right down to the floor. And then begin to lift those hips. Keep that grip on those heels. Begin to walk those knees forward. Keep that grip. Keep those heels together. Belly in. Throat is choked. Pull those shoulders down away from the ears. Keep those hips lifted. Pull that belly in tighter. Good. Release those hips down. Then bring that head up. Head comes up last. Good. Now come to a seated position. Let's just cross at our ankles here. Nice seated pose. We'll bring that right forearm down. Let's reach over with that left arm. Keeping both sit bones flat on the floor. Keep the belly in. Let's do the other side. So left forearm down. Reach over with that right arm. Keep that right sit bone down. Good. Bring it back to center. Let's extend that right leg and bring that left foot in nice and close. Let's bring those arms up overhead. Turn to face that right foot and bring it down. Interlacing those fingers if you can underneath that foot to get a nice tight grip. And then bring your forehead right down to that knee. Now, if your forehead can't reach the knee, slightly bend that knee until you get that connection. So it's a compression posture, it's not stretching toes. Keep those shoulders square to the floor, keep those sit bones flat, belly in. Good, release those hands from the foot. Bend that right foot for me. Right knee, I should say. And then take that left foot and bring it right on top. Bring that heel close to your backside, hands in nice and close. So you sit up nice and tall. So you create this figure four. You should feel that on the outside of that left leg. And then slowly bring that foot down to the mat and just give it a nice good old fashioned twist. And bring it back center, we're going to move into cow face. So bring that right knee in front of our center. Stack it with the left knee so your heels are nice and close. You can stay right here, make sure those sit bones are flat. And then if you want to, you can come to that full expression, reaching those arms out, bringing that forehead down, and chest right over those legs. Good. into pigeon before we do the other side. So just open up those legs. You're gonna stack those shins. Feet are flexed. Make sure those sit bones are flat again. Again, you can stay right here. Or you can walk those arms out again, come into that full expression. Good, and then walk those hands back. Let's do the other side. So extend the left leg. Pull that right foot in nice and close. Flex the left foot. Bring those arms up overhead. Turn to face that foot. Bring it down. Bending that knee as much as you need to get that interlaced grip. Hands back. Let's stack those shins. Flex those feet. Walk it out if you want.